In this short lesson, I want to talk about Project Jupyter. Now, we have IPython, which is a specific version of Python. It is for interactive computing. Now, we can use IPython just normally in a command line interface, but we are going to use it in a notebook format. Now, it used to be called the IPython notebook, seeing that it was specifically developed, or at least initially developed for IPython. But the notebook, or the project behind the notebook, has really expanded to include quite a few other programming languages as well. Therefore, the name was changed to Jupyter, that is with a Y, and you can see it there. So when you install the Jupyter notebooks, when you install IPython, let's call it Python for that matter, we still go to ipython.org and we're still going to click on install. This is what's going to pop up now. And what you really want to do is just to say that I am a new user, new to Python and Jupyter. And still there we find Anaconda, just as we had before. Anaconda is the installation that we're going to use. It really contains IPython, it contains Project Jupyter, and it contains a lot of added packages that we are going to use in this course. So if we click on Anaconda, we'll see that page open from Continuum Analytics. And there we see Anaconda for Windows, you can see there. And we also get for Mac OS and for Linux. We're going to use Python version 3, as is now up to version 3.5. And depending on your computer, it's either going to be a 64-bit or 32-bit graphic installer. That is what you want to click on, and that is what you're going to install. Now, that installation will run automatically depending on your operating system. And once it is installed, this is what we're going to get up to. This is a console. We just call it terminal in macOS. It's called the command line in Windows. And if we want to update our installation, once it's installed, conda is the command we're looking for. We can say conda update conda. That will conda with an N. That will just update conda, which is what manages all these packages for us. So every now and again, run that. We see I'm up to date. No problems there. And then conda update anaconda. And that will update most of the packages that is installed. Please remember also, though, to update Jupyter. And it is spelled with a Y. Now, initially, I think it started off by all the names. So J-U was for Julia, P-Y for Python, and lots of other languages in there as well. So Project Jupyter. So just update Jupyter as well. And there we have it. Now, to start Python, to start the program off, as we're going to use in most of this course, we just type in Jupyter notebook. Jupyter notebook. There we go. That is how we're going to launch. So you have to find the terminal in macOS, the terminal in your Linux operating system, or the command line program in Windows. Once that open up, use the conda update conda, conda update anaconda, and conda update Jupyter every now and again just to keep all your packages up to date. And then when you want to run your IPython installation, the way that we're going to use it in a notebook, in the browser, we type Jupyter notebook. If we hit a return or enter, that launches Jupyter notebook, almost exactly the same as the old IPython notebooks that you'll see throughout this course. All the files on GitHub, though, have been updated for Jupyter. So when you download the newest version of Anaconda that contains IPython, that contains all the packages, that contains Jupyter to run in your browser here, all those files will work. So, Project Jupyter, give it a download.